Hello, I'm Domenica Marland from the Iris Letter, and today I'm going to be talking about Peggy Guggenheim, who was an art queen in the early modern 20th century. Here we are standing on 30 Cork Street. We all know Peggy Guggenheim for being the person who created her palazzo into an art gallery, but we don't know much about her time in London. In 1930, Peggy Guggenheim came to London from Paris after she had divorced her first husband, Lawrence Vale. She started a 5-year romance with a man called John Holmes, who was a writer. Sadly, their relationship ended after 5 years when he died in surgery. She's always said that he was her one true love. To occupy herself, she thought she would open her first gallery, called Guggenheim June, right here. The gallery's first show was of drawings by Jean Cocteau, although a drawing in the show was too subversive of the female vagina and had to be taken off. Customs wouldn't allow it. So Peggy bought the drawing herself and kept it in her office just over there, and always left the door ajar so people would see it when they were coming to visit the gallery. The second show in 1938 was a small Kandinsky show. Sadly, no works were bought, so Peggy Guggenheim bought a few works herself anonymously to make him feel better. Unfortunately, after a year of the gallery being open, in 1939, it had to close. It was a great success, but they made a loss of £600 and had a fun farewell party and closed the gallery. Then she went on to bigger things, but this is where the magic started.